very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Sadhna More, a student manager of Balaji Institute of International Business, take immense pleasure in introducing you all to our today's guest speaker, Mr. D.V. Shastry, Executive Director, HRD, GAIL India Limited. Sir D.V. Shastry, who has done M.Tech in Energy Systems Engineering from IIT Bombay, with PG Diploma in Management and an Advanced Certificate in HRM, has over 32 years of experience in hydrocarbon industry with human resource function for almost two decades. Prior to pursuing his passion in HR and HRD function, he has had an experience of several years in the technical field, which includes project management, operation and maintenance of gas compressor station and the gas processing complex, etc., of Messrs. GAIL. He has received as well as contributed to awards as an individual and as a team member. For example, ISTD, Emerging HRD Thinker Award, Best HR Strategy in Line with Business, National Award for Innovative Training Process, Golden Peacock Award, Green Tech Award, Sword of Honor, Sarvashresht Suraksha Puraskar, NPMP Award for DVPL Project, and the list goes on. Recently, he has been conferred with Distinguished Scholar Award by ISOL Global Foundation in Chicago, USA. He has also been a member of several professional bodies like SHRM, NHRDN, NIPM, ASME, IE, etc. He is a sought-after orator and has been invited as speaker in various reputed national and international institutions in prestigious events. So I request you all to please join me in welcoming Mr. D.V. Shastry to address us with his words of wisdom. Welcome, sir. The stage is all yours.
Very good morning and namaskar to all of you. It is indeed a matter of great pleasure for me to be here with all of you at this Balaji Institute of International Business. And I must thank the organizers for selecting the theme of the business convention as the next generation leadership and navigating the future, which is a very pertinent and relevant topic in the current days. So before I start interacting with you, I would like to know how many HR and non-HR people are sitting here. So those who are HR can raise their hands. Okay. And that means others are non-HR?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us start our interaction from here itself. Never say that you are non-HR, because the moment we are born on this earth and till our last breath, we ourselves are a human being and we keep interacting with human beings all the time. Can we ever imagine to exist without interacting with other human beings? No. So, when we take birth, with whom do we interact first? Our mother. Then father, other family members, then we go to the school, to college, we seek some job, and so on and so forth. And while performing our duty as an employee also, we have some boss to whom we report, we have some peers, we have subordinates, and so on. And the success of any individual in any profession, be it a doctor, be it a manager, be it a lawyer, and so on and so forth, it is only because he or she is able to handle the team or the people in a nice manner. Those who can handle properly, they succeed. Those who are not able to, they fail. Right or wrong? So henceforth, you never say that somebody is HR and somebody is non-HR. Everybody is? Okay. If you learn this thing by heart, if you keep this thing in mind, because you know, all of us have our families. घर में जो बर्तन सफाई करने वाली काम वाली भी आती है उसको अगर आप properly treat करोगे तो वो आपका दो काम ज़्यादा कर देगी, और नहीं तो वो बोलेगी मैं नौकरी छोड़ के जा रही हूँ, और आपकी मदर को या आपके दूसरे फैमिली मेम्बर्स को कितना कष्ट होगा ये हम में से हर व्यक्ति जानता है. सही या गलत? तो सेम थिंग अप्लाइज टू the organization as well, the whatever is available applicable to us as a small unit at family level, it is applicable to the organization as well. Now, coming to the organization, you can see that any organization also cannot exist in vacuum. It has to operate in its own business environment. And the business environment consists of so many factors. We have got economic scenario, we have got political scenario, we have got social scenario, we have got, legal environment, we have got regulatory environment, and so on and so forth. So the success of business can be achieved only if the organization has robust strategies and plans to cope up with the situation in the environment. Those who are able to adapt to the environment, they succeed, others don't. But what I want to emphasize through this slide is that whatever strategy you plan, whatever vision you have, whatever policies, processes, systems you have, who will make all those things happen? It is only the people. So people are at the core of the heart of any organization, and they only lead to its success or failure. So if you pay attention, if you focus on the people, you make them competent, you take care of them, your organization will achieve new heights, and those who don't pay attention, they perish. Nowadays, a lot of things are being talked about Industry 4.0, that is Fourth Industrial Revolution. Then we talk of Fourth Industrial Revolution in terms of fusion of technologies, and there is a blurring of lines between the physical, digital, and biological spheres, and collectively we refer all these to as cyber-physical systems. We also talk so many things about the artificial intelligence, nanotechnology, quantum computing, 3D printing, autonomous vehicles, and so on. So all these developments are taking place very rapidly, and they are having very deep impact on the global economy. And more popular management jargon these days is disruptive innovation. It is disrupting almost every industry in every country, and it is leading to the transformation of entire systems of production, management, and governance. But there is nothing to worry about. Change is the only thing which is constant. Yes, its pace may be higher or lower, whatever you call it, disruptive innovation or whatever. Don't worry. It is the people who will cope with it. Artificial intelligence may be there, but it is the human intelligence which will prevail over everything. Artificial intelligence is only to support the human beings. The human beings are the controllers and not the other way around. So what is the key to success in developing the next generation leadership and navigating the future? The only answer is knowledge leadership. Today's global economy is knowledge economy. So those organizations who have an ability to learn faster than their competitors will only be the leaders, and they will only succeed. And this will happen if the members of the organization have an intense quest for knowledge. And also, in earlier days, people used to say work should be meaningful, but now the work is required to be more learningful. Each activity has to have certain learning in it for all the members of the organization, so that there is a culture of innovation and creativity. Newer things are being explored and people are coming out with new ideas. If somebody has had a chance to go through the book called The Fifth Discipline by Peter Senge, has anybody gone through that book? No. It's a very famous book in which the author emphasizes about developing learning organization. And a learning organization is nothing but an organization where the people are continuously expanding their capacities and new ideas to create the results they truly desire, and where the patterns of thinking are set free, and more importantly, people are learning to learn together. That is how the concept of learning organization has been introduced by that author, and that is the key to the success in the present day scenario. Friends, as we all know, curiosity or the quest to explore is one of the natural instincts of a human being. When a child is born and he or she is little bit grown up, they start asking questions: what is this, what is that? They don't know what is a crow, so the child will ask mother 100 times, what is that? Then the mother will keep telling, this is crow, and so on. So now my point is that human beings keep learning from every moment, every encounter, and every experience of life. Even now we are in the learning mode. I am learning something from you. You are getting something from me. Each one of you is getting some learning from the others, and so on. So it is the quest for knowledge, or the jnana pipasa, as we say in Sanskrit, which drives an individual to learn not just from their teachers or parents, but also from the first-hand experiences in life. Because, say, for example, if we preach somebody, that is not easily understandable. Like when, let us take the example of child only. If candle is burning and mother says, don't go near the flame, and child still goes, ek bar jab haath jal jata hai, tab pata chal jata hai ki candle ke flame ko haath nahi lagana hai. So that is experiential learning. Maa ne 50 bar kaha, usko samajh mein nahi aaya, ek bar haath jal gaya, to samajh mein aa gaya. Aapko samajh mein aa raha hai ki nahi? Theek hai. To, and each individual has a keen desire to excel, acquire name and fame, and create an influence in one's own domain. Kiski ichcha nahi hoti ki wo mashhoor ho, ya log usko recognize kare, ya uska society mein maan samman ho. Ye to sabki ichcha rehti hai. And that kind of desire, which is, there is nothing wrong in it. If somebody works hard for such thing, there is nothing wrong in it. It must be there. So that exactly constitutes the basis for leadership, whether it is at organizational level or beyond. Now I would like to quote the Bhagavad Gita in the context of quest for knowledge. Krishna says to Arjun, nahi jnanena sadrisham pavitra mehe vidyate. There is nothing purer or purifier like knowledge in this world. And it is the genuine quest which leads to acquisition of knowledge. Now, having recognized that knowledge is the most powerful tool, and it only enables and empowers the individual, how to acquire it? Again, Krishna advises Arjuna. He says, tad viddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. That means, attain that knowledge by prostrating yourself before the feet of the wise people, render them services, and question them with a pure heart again and again. This is from chapter 4, verse 38. But a word of caution. There is a sharp difference between argument and genuine questioning. If somebody is asking some question with the genuine intent to know something, then yes, it is the real meaningful dialogue or exchange of ideas. But there are many people who just want to enter into argument just to belittle someone. There are many students also in the classroom who ask the questions to the professor only for the sake of asking only, or just to play mischief or to embarrass the professor. But there are genuine students also who have genuine quest to know, and they approach the faculty with a sense of humility and keen desire to know the things. So that should be the approach of the students and the would-be corporate citizens. I can see there are so many corporate citizens, future corporate citizens sitting here. So if you enter the corporate world with this kind of attitude, there is no reason why you cannot succeed. You will achieve newer heights. So the key aspects in acquisition or search of knowledge are genuineness, purity of heart, humility, and logical reasoning and questioning. So that is the essence of learning in true sense. So as we discussed in the beginning, today's environment has become very complex. Innovative disruption you call, or disruptive innovation you call, or you call VUCA environment, and so on and so forth. In such a complex environment, it is not only the academic knowledge, but acquaintance with several other aspects and expertise in some field is required to become successful as a corporate citizen. Otherwise, there is no survival. As we all know, it is the fittest who can survive. And therefore, there is a strong need to equip oneself with all-round knowledge and skills to survive in this cutthroat competition in this corporate world. This VUCA environment, I won't go much into the details. I presume that all of you are familiar with this jargon.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. But what is the treatment for that? How many of you know that? What is the antidote for VUCA? Does anyone know? Yes or no? Okay, so let us concentrate on that. Having acknowledged that the business environment is characterized by volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity, so what is the way out? How to fight it? So the first and foremost thing is clarity of vision in the leadership. And uncertainty can be combated by the ability of the leaders to understand beyond their functional area of expertise. Suppose if somebody is an expert in finance, in today's complex environment, he cannot succeed by remaining only a finance man. He has to know about HR, he has to know about marketing, and so on and so forth. So that is the ability of leaders to understand beyond their area of expertise. Then complexity of the problems. We know no problem is simple. So complexity can be overcome by clarity of thoughts and to make sense out of the chaotic environment. Avyavastha se ki andar se bhi vyavastha dhundna. To find order from the disorder. That is the quality which is required in modern leaders. And to fight the aspect of ambiguity, it is the ability, or agility rather, not ability, agility to communicate across the organization and move quickly to apply the solutions arrived at through consensus within the organization. It is not one man's decision, it is a collective decision, it is collective wisdom which has to be applied to arrive at the solution to complex problems. So therefore, what is the key to success of organization? That is, we have to grow leaders. Even I had the chance to go through a very good book called The Toyota Way. It is authored by Professor Jeffrey Leiker, who is the professor and head of Japanese Management Studies at the University of Michigan. In his book, he has mentioned 14 management principles based on which the Toyota Corporation achieved success. And one of the principles among those 14 principles is they believe in growing leaders that understand and live the philosophy of the organization and share and teach it to the other members of the organization in the interest of long-term and sustained growth of the organization. So in the current time, there has to be a fundamental shift in the leadership approach, and some of the key points I would like to touch upon. Number one is leading from behind. Gone are those days that in the typical cartoons or the picture we used to see that leaders is marching ahead and the masses are following. Yes, it happens, but the beauty is in leading from behind. So in this current scenario, things are changing so fast that often it is not clear exactly where an organization requires to go. What are the strategic moves which should be taken by the organization? So therefore, it is the ability to take decisions in the relevant context, and decision can be right or wrong. It is, if you aspire to take, to make all decisions which are correct only, it is not possible. We learn from our mistakes. Some decisions will be right, some will be wrong. As in our culture, Hindu culture, we say, nirnay jo hai wo desh kaal aur paristhiti ke mutabik liye jate hain. Desh means space, kaal means time, and paristhiti is circumstances. So every decision is contextual. Many times people say that my predecessor took all such decisions which were proven to be wrong. But who knows, whatever decision we are taking now is the absolute correct decision in true sense? No. So the person holding that position at that point of time took into consideration all contextual factors and took some decision. Later on it may prove to be right or wrong, but decision must be taken. Indecision is the biggest enemy to the growth of any organization. Second thing, the complexity of the business environment makes the notion of leader as expert as irrelevant. Pehle bolte the ki bhai wo senior position mein hai, wo bada jankar aadmi hai. Whatever he says, blindly follow that. But now, gone are those days. Nobody can claim to be the expert in all the fields. And therefore, it is the collective wisdom or the decision making through consensus that proves to be more effective, and that is the need of the hour in the current times. And one more thing, that your words may have some impact, but it is a well-known saying that actions speak louder than words. If I keep telling my team members, do this, do that, perhaps they will only listen, ek kaan se sun ke dusre kaan se nikal denge. Suppose if I ask them to be punctual, and if I am myself not punctual, will they really listen to me? Similar thing in every aspect. So you have to be the leader by example. You have to be the role model. Again, I am very fond of quoting the Bhagavad Gita time and again. It says, yad yada charati shreshthas tatta deve tarojanah sayat pramanam kurute lokas tadanu vartate. This means whatever proposition is made and whatever conduct is demonstrated by the leader, the team members or the masses follow the same. And whatever evidence he produces or whatever proposition he comes forward with is followed by the masses or the team members. So in the context of organizational leadership in these complex times, it is more important to demonstrate the things through conduct rather than leading by example. So leaders have to demonstrate through their own conduct whatever they want others to behave or to demonstrate, they should first demonstrate. And leaders should focus on getting the best out of group by letting people use their own judgment. Dusre ke upar judgment thopna nahi hai, unki raay leni hai, and take risk. Thoda risk bhi lena padega while you are leading from behind. Ab aapko yahan pe jaise corporate relation ki team hai ya yahan pe sare students hi manage kar rahe hain is program ko, ho sakta hai usme kuch galtiyan honge, lekin agar Bala sir sochenge ki bhai main hi sab kuch plan karke dunga, मैं ही जो बताऊंगा वही स्टूडेंट्स करेंगे या वही प्रोफेसर पादी करेंगे या वही प्रोफेसर रश्मि महाजन करेंगी, देन इट इज़ नॉट ए गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ लीडरशिप. ठीक है, गलती होगी तो सीख जाएंगे. हेवन इज नॉट गोइंग टू फॉल, एंड लेट इट फॉल इवन इफ इट कम्स टू दैट, देन ओनली वी विल बी एबल टू अचीव रियल लर्निंग एंड ग्रोथ इन दिस कॉम्पिटिटिव एरा. एंड अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट इज identify adaptive challenges. You know, for the organizational strategy to succeed, the company's leader needs to understand the challenges faced, the people, that means the own team, and the potential sources of conflict that may arise in the course of organizational working. Few more important things which are required to develop the futuristic leaders is create collective leadership. Encourage the people who have divisive issues. Kisi ki asahmati ko aap ye mat maniye ki usko aap overrule karenge. Rather, rather than indulging in scapegoating or finding fault, try to respect the divergent views expressed by the team members. Instill a collective self-confidence rather than controlling people. Let them be confident. ठीक है थोड़ा सा गलत भी हो जाएगा सही भी हो जाएगा करते करते सीखेंगे and they will be confident to take bold decisions in future in the long-term interest of the organization. Then today's leaders have to provide direction by defining key issues and values. The real leaders do encourage the risk-taking and responsibility. And the most important thing is that we have to help the people from the team to recognize that only they contain the solution. If some problem has come up, it is not that in like old days, you go to the leader with problem, whatever solution he gives, you implement it. No, it is the team which has got the solution because the team members are working in the front. Leader is there for providing the overall direction and to share good things from his own experience so that the team can be enabled to make informed and wise decision making. And another thing which many of the leaders do not follow and they fail, there are many examples in the world. Don't silence whistleblowers and creative deviants and others exposing contradictions within the company, as their perspectives can provoke fresh thinking. The past president of US, Richard Nixon, he was not, you know, taking the proper feedback. Even in country, I won't take the name, but yes, there was a lady prime minister who was dictatorial in her approach, and that led to many difficulties in her time. So that is at the political level. Similarly, in the business organizations also, if we do not respect the divergent views from various team members, then the leadership is bound to fail. Now coming to the academic institutions like Balaji Institute or any institute for that matter, the most important parameter for its success is the ability to offer a meaningful and effective corporate interface. Normally what I have seen through my experience that the institutes do send the students for internship in industry or the business entities. But many of them, not all, but many students do it only for the sake of formality. They come and go to the organization, they say, mujhe to aap 2 mahine ka certificate de dena, 3 mahine ka de dena, aur main to first day aa jaunga ya aa jaungi, or final day mein, or any other field of knowledge. Suppose if I am teaching mechanical engineering and I am talking about gas turbine, okay, I must have read gas turbine in books, but if I have not seen it physically or if I have not had the hands-on working experience, maybe for a short time, then I cannot prove to be a good faculty member, because if I talk of, say, labyrinth seal, if I have not seen the labyrinth scene at all, I only see in the book, in the picture, I can never explain the thing to the students in a proper manner. What is bearing, what is tilting pad bearing, what is journal bearing, what is bleed wall, and so on and so forth. So the faculty from the academic institutions should also have the exposure to the industry and corporate world in real sense to get the real feel of the business or the industry, so as to make the academic curriculum in such institutions more meaningful and effective. And another interesting thing I would like to share with you is that what are the expectations which the industry has from the fresh entrants. I share here with the findings of one of the surveys which reveals that industry has highest expectations from the newly hired executives in the areas like they should have a positive attitude, that is the first and the foremost thing, commitment, dedication, self-discipline, and an aptitude and willingness to learn. That is the most important factor which the industry expects from the students. And again, I have collected some data. That is, we discussed what is required to be and what is the reality. You can see that against the attribute of aptitude and willingness to learn, expectations of industry, that is 93% of the industries gave top priority to this parameter, and actual performance of the students against this was only 47%, meaning thereby a gap of 46%. Similarly, creativity is another trait which the industry looks for in the new entrants, and again in this area there was a gap of 54%. Self-discipline, difference of almost 60%. So I must appreciate, I was told that Balaji Institute is working 365 days a year, and there is never a holiday, and people, the focus is on making the students self-dependent and so on. So if that is there, and people are disciplined within the campus and otherwise also, then they will be more successful in getting a good job in a good corporate, and vice versa. So you here also you can see that at the top is learning only, which we discussed very much in detail a short while ago. So, and that means these are the three gears meshing with each other: industry, students, and the institutions. So in today's complex scenario, students must be working on realistic expectations. There is no dream job. People might be thinking, jaise shaadi mein hota na ki ladka sochta hai wo ladki jo hai khoobsurat bhi ho, hain wo naukri bhi achhi karti ho, paise bhi acche kamati ho, khana bhi accha banati ho, to aisi sarvagun sampann ladki kahin nahi milti. Aisa hi jo aise hi agar aap job ke bare mein sochenge ki maine jitna padha hai usko main directly apply kar paunga, ye meri cheez maine sikhi hai isko main design karunga ya isko aise implement, aisa realistic world mein aisa kuch nahi hota. There is nothing ideal in this world. Ideal is only a concept. Aap chemistry mein ideal gas padhte hain, koi ideal gas aapne aaj tak suni hai? Nahi suni hai. So there is always something ideal which is as a benchmark, but there are realities, and there is always a gap between the ideal and the reality. So the students must also be working on realistic expectations, and most important, changing the belief that degree alone will get you the job. There is much beyond the degree, getting degree. You can see a live example. Many people are moving with so many degrees without jobs, and maybe simple graduates are doing wonders in the corporate world. As far as industry is concerned, it has to focus on frequent learning and development programs. It has to have clear reward and recognition mechanisms, and also to provide autonomy to the employees. It has to have fairness and transparency while dealing with employees and various stakeholders. And coming to the academic institutions, as I mentioned just a short while ago, they must work on the skills and attitude apart from knowledge. And perhaps I must compliment BIIB and other institutions of this group, that there is a lot of emphasis on shaping the aptitude and attitude of the students apart from getting the theoretical knowledge in the classroom. Then case methodology is one of the powerful tools in developing good future leadership, and frequent industry interaction should be there and meaningful. Aisa nahi wo kagaz wala nahi ki internship aaj aapne attendance laga diya aur do mahine baad certificate leke aa gaye. Aap hi ka fayda hoga. I can tell you from my personal first hand experience. There is a lot of difference if your approach is different. So we talked about the framework or the guiding principles so far. Now I would like to share the experience gained by me in my company, which I take pride in saying my company. It is the youngest Maharatna company, and I am very proud to share with all of you that I have been associated with this company right from its birth. 16th of August 1984 was the date when this company was formed, and that time I was an ONGC employee. It became a separate company out of ONGC, and within a very short span of time, it is the youngest Maharatna. It became Maharatna in the year 2013 only. Prior to it, it became Navaratna in 1997. Its mission and vision you can see, but the primary vision is to be the global company in natural gas and beyond, with global focus and commitment to the customers and all stakeholders, value creation for them, and with environmental responsibility, which is the backbone of petrochemical plant, LPG pipeline, into LNG import, into your LPG storage, into E&P also, because you know the concept of forward integration and backward integration. When the company moves towards the source side, it is backward integration, and when it goes to the supply side, it is forward integration. So until now we were dependent on ONGC for the gas supply, so we have to have some source with our own. So that's why GAIL entered into E&P also, and now we are having operations at global level also. We have got a gas trading office in Singapore, we have got an office in the United States, we have got equity investments in China and also Egypt and so on. So the operations are now at global level, and it is in such a short span of time. These are the business portfolios of GAIL, as you can see, and as I mentioned just now, we are aggressively looking at exploring the international opportunities and to become a global player in true sense. Obviously, the HR function is a strategic partner with the business, and the focus is on creation of resources by talent acquisition and retention, because it is the first step, the first day when the person is taken into the organization, that's very important. Agar ek aadmi galat aadmi company mein aa gaya to wo 30-35 saal tak aajkal chalo log jaldi jaldi job change bhi karte tab bhi 5-10 saal ke liye bhi raha to ek machli talab ko ganda bhi kar sakti hai. So we have to be very serious in quality of the people who are being recruited, development of human resource strategy and technology, conductive environment for sustainable growth by building the right kind of culture, systems, policies and processes, and to aim and focus on individual excellence and self-development while the collective excellence is achieved. And collective excellence is possible only when individuals are excelling, and the synergy of actions between the individuals leads to the organizational success. A few quick highlights about my company. It's a lean and thin organization. We are hardly 4,500 employees, right from chairman to the junior most employees, while our turnover is of the order of more than 53,000 crore rupees last year's turnover, and the profit was the highest ever profit in the history of the company. It was 4,618 crores of rupees. And the organization is professional skill dominated one. We believe in adopting the latest technology, and we also pay lot of attention and emphasis on cross-functional expertise. As I mentioned to you earlier, if somebody is engineer, it does not mean that he will confine himself only to the tools and machines. He should also have the knowledge of marketing. He should also know the financial aspects of business. He also has to be an HR manager first, because he has to lead the team and so on. So cross-functional expertise is one of the focus areas. More of executives, we have more than 80% of the executives in our people strength. Our age is also fairly young, not so young as it was before. Earlier when we started as a company, the early average age was around 30-32, but at present it is around 42 years. Attrition rate is very meager, it is less than 1%, and one of the key strengths of our company is free and open communication. People are free to express their opinion at any level, and that is what gives a unique strength to GAIL India Limited. This I have mentioned to you. Now another myth in the minds of people. People say ki PSUs are sarkari companies and they have chalta hai attitude and culture. There is bureaucracy, there is insensitivity and so on and so forth. But I must say from my personal experience with such a long association with this company, I can say with confidence that at GAIL we believe L&D as an area of investment. The development of people, the learning of people is investment, it is not expenditure. Although yes, worldwide it is a common presumption that training is an expenditure, in GAIL we do not believe so. And it is also very common to say that human resources are the most precious resources of a company. We truly believe in it and we have truly demonstrated it so far. Also, there is people think that there is no scope for, you know, innovation, creativity, or, you know, to do experiment in a PSU. But it is not so. The reality is that if you really want to work or really want to contribute, sky is the limit. Sky is the limit if you have will to perform. Simply blaming the systems or processes won't do. If you want to do, if you have a fire in the belly, PSUs are the right platform to work. Perhaps rather the contrary should be true, that private organizations may not be providing that much flexibility as the PSUs do. Say for example, my personal examples I can share with you. When I got inducted into the company, I was in the hardcore the technical role. I was into pipeline construction, then I got the exposure into compressor station, then the LPG plant came up, LPG recovery from natural gas. Then my posting was at corporate office, so corporate exposure. Then when the training institute came into existence in the year 97, again I was among the core faculty members. Then from that role of faculty, I was again given the challenging task of executing the Dahej-Vijaypur pipeline project with a cost of 3,000 crore rupees, which we executed ahead of time. Then after completion of that project, I was heading the entire gas complex in a place called Vijaypur in Madhya Pradesh. And then again, I was moved back to the training institute as its head, then into HRD function, and today I am before you. So nobody should say that ki mauka nahi milta ya favoritism hai ya kuch hi logon ko karte hain ya aap ek hi jagah stagnate hote hain. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Aapko agar karne ki ichcha hai, fire in the belly hai, sky is the limit and you can do anything which you like. In PSUs there is tremendous empowerment also. I am remembering the old days, year 1988, my service was only 4 years, and that time we were in the process of setting an LPG plant in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So our chairman, who was an IAS officer at that point of time, he said, arrange a meeting with the chief secretary of Madhya Pradesh. That time I was posted in MP. A person, a boy, having only a 4 years experience, he was asked by the chairman to seek an appointment from the chief secretary of the state, and I did that, because I was empowered by my CMD. Then when the meeting took place with the chief secretary, our chairman clearly told that if you can give us clearance in 15 days, we will set up the plant, otherwise we will take it elsewhere. So the chief secretary constituted a very high level committee, like the chairman of pollution control board, the chief of town and country planning, and you name the authority, they were there in that committee. So chief secretary said that, okay, now I am constituting this committee here and now. Who will coordinate from your side? My chairman said, he pointed at me, that he is the person who will represent GAIL. So you see the extent of empowerment. So you should remove the notion, if you have in your minds, that PSU mein sarkari kaam hota hai, kaam latakta rehta hai, kaam dheere hota hai, aisa kuch nahi hai. And when I was given the challenging task, my CMD said that, okay, now I have done my job. I have told the chief secretary, he has committed. Now you take them to the site, you explain the project, you do everything whatever is required, and on 15th day, I want clearance in my hand at Delhi. Whatever was required to be done, I did. Site visit karwana hai, vehicle arrange karna hai, wo sari chiz. Aur ek chiz jarur jaan lo. Abhi main batata hu, ek HR ka ladka abhi humne recruit kiya tha, usko kisi site pe bheja. Wo do din ke baad kehta hai, sahab yahan to mere layak kaam hi nahi hai. Main jo padh ke aaya hu, wo to hai labor laws ka, main kahan implementation kar raha hu, main HRD theories ko kahan apply kar raha hu. Yahan to khali administrative job hai, yahan to employees ka payroll dekhna hai, yahan to unke claims ko address karna hai. ऐसा अगर जो सोचता है वो सबसे बड़ा मूर्ख है. और मुझे खुशी है कि वो तीसरे दिन रिजाइन करके चला गया. अरे भाई ये क्या बात है, आप कंपनी के एम्प्लॉय हो, थोड़ा तो पेशेंस भी तो रखो. दो दिन में आपने पता कर लिया कि यहाँ पे आपके नॉलेज का कोई एप्लीकेशन नहीं है. हैं, क्या वो सही था वो लड़का? हमने कहा बहुत अच्छा हुआ कि ऐसा आदमी तो मेरी कंपनी से चला गया, तो मुझे तो बहुत खुशी हुई. बताइए, दो दिन में नखरे कर रहा है. तो मैं आपसे इसलिए शेयर कर रहा हूँ कि आप लोग भी अभी उसी फेज में जो है जाने वाले हो. तो हो सकता है मेनी टाइम्स मैनेजमेंट यूजेस दिस थिंग टू टेस्ट योर एटीट्यूड और अप्रोच टुवर्ड्स वर्क. सो यू शुड नॉट यू नो बिकम ए यू नो विक्टिम ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग. मैं अपनी बात बता रहा हूँ, मैं अपनी बात इसलिए बता रहा हूँ, मैं अपनी यहाँ बड़ाई करने नहीं आया, लेकिन मेरी अच्छाई बुराई जो भी उससे आपको शेयर करूं, तो शायद आप उन चीज़ों से दूर रहें जिनसे हम दूर ना रह पाए, या जो जिन चीज़ों से हमने सीखा. जैसे मैं IIT बॉम्बे से पढ़ के आया था, नौकरी लगी, अगले दिन जब मैंने ज्वाइन किया, उज्जैन वॉज द प्लेस इन मध्य प्रदेश वेर आई ज्वाइन. एंड ज्वाइन करते ही फर्स्ट डे माई बॉस, ही वॉज ए महाराष्ट्रियन AP पटवर्धन, ही टोल्ड मी दैट यू गो टू सच एंड सच विलेज अलॉन्ग विद दिस तहसीलदार. Because the role of tehsildar is that when we lay the pipelines, we have to acquire the right of user. We don't acquire the land on permanent basis, but we take the 30-meter wide strip through which we do the trenching, lay the pipeline, and then the land is restored. So for that purpose, the revenue department of the concerned state is associated, and it is the engineer and that revenue officer have to go to the field for verification of the technical service, so that the compensation can be given to the farmers for the damage which will be caused to their crops while the pipeline is being laid. So he told me that aap kal subah 5 baje chale jao, aapke ghar pe gaadi aa jayegi aur ye Vishwakarma ji hain tehsildar, ye aapke saath jayenge. Ab do approach ho sakte the, ya to main bhi ye jo ladke ka maine example diya, मैं ऐसे ही करता है कि मैं IIT बॉम्बे से ये गांव में धक्के खाने के लिए तहसीलदार के साथ जाने के लिए हूँ, हेल विद दिस. और दूसरा अप्रोच था कि हाँ भाई ठीक है, चलो कुछ सीखने को मिलेगा भाई, कॉलेज में तो बहुत सी पढ़ाई करके आ गए, IIT में अलग एनवायरनमेंट था, जरा प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ को भी देखें. गए और उसके बाद वो एटीट्यूड जब आपका देख लेते हैं ना सीनियर्स, देन यू गेट लॉट ऑफ ग्रोथ अपॉर्चुनिटीज़. मेरा करियर कैसे बिल्ड हुआ, ऐसे ही हुआ, जो काम दिया उसको अच्छे से करो. And even if you have a difference of opinion, you should first have a positive approach. Suppose आपको लगता भी है, मान लीजिए ऐसा कभी होगा नहीं, पर किसी ने कह दिया आप झाड़ू लगाइए, आप तो ऑफेंड हो जाओगे कि ये क्या, मैं झाड़ू लगाने के लिए बालाजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस से पढ़ के आया हूँ? लेकिन आप उस चीज़ को पोलाइटली कहिए, सर यस इफ नीड बी आई कैन डू दैट, बट सर आई थिंक मिस्टर एक्स has already been employed for housekeeping services, so if you don't mind, may I request him to do that? And sir, yes, if nobody is there, if it is the need of the hour, yes, jolly well I'll do it. If Prime Minister is visiting my institute, there is no one there, no point, no problem, I'll take the broom and clean the room, right? So again, the concept of desh kal and paristhiti. वो भी आप देखिए कि आपके सीनियर ने आपको जो कुछ कहा वो क्यों कहा, किस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में कहा. आप खाली फेस वैल्यू पे मत लीजिए. एम आई टॉकिंग सेंस? ओके. बीच बीच में सबको जगाना भी जरूरी रहता है ना. So these examples of empowerment, etc., I have given you. And there are a lot of opportunities for experimenting. ज़्यादा लंबा हो गया, एक बजने वाला कब खत्म करें? हैं? Should I go ahead or? Are you enjoying or you are saying just like that? नहीं, मैं भी समझ रहा हूँ कि वो जो फर्स्ट पार्ट था वो थोड़ा सा थ्योरेटिकल फ्रेमवर्क था, उसमें लोगों को थोड़ी नींद आ रही थी, लेकिन जब आप रियल एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करते हो तो शायद लोगों को उसमें इंटरेस्ट आता है ना? ठीक है, तो लेट अस गो ऑन, बट आई अश्योर यू आई वोंट टेक टू लॉन्ग, आई विल टच ओनली सम ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक एस्पेक्ट्स. देन वन कैन डू लॉट ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट for self-development as well as that of organization. It is, again, I am grateful to my company. I got several opportunities to undergo training in India and abroad. I visited so many countries for specific training programs and also to participate in international conferences, seminars, etc. First, as a delegate attending the seminar, and now in the recent years as a speaker in those international events. So I am grateful to my company for that. Then company also gave me exposure to contribute at national level. There was a NAFOG, that is National Association for Oil and Gas, wherein we worked on the skill set requirements in the oil sector in our country. Then when the petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board was constituted, जैसे TRAI होता है कि नहीं, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, वैसे ही PNGR भी है, Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board in our sector. So that sector also took a very, mammoth exercise of, identifying the skill gaps in the city gas distribution sector. You have got this Maharashtra Natural Gas Company in Pune, which is doing the activity of city gas distribution and CNG, which that is also our joint venture. GAIL has several joint ventures in the area of city gas distribution and CNG in various states. So there we took the task, because it is very difficult. CNG and PNG, piped natural gas, these are relatively new areas in our country, so where we need specific skill sets. So a task force was constituted by that board, and I was made the head of that committee. So once you take up such assignments, you get a sense of pride. As I told you in that theoretical framework, har aadmi ki ichcha hoti ki usko kuch recognition mile, usko yash mile, kiski ichcha nahi hoti. To wo jab aapko is tarah ka company se platform milta hai, when you get the opportunities to make your contribution in the outside world on behalf of your company, that gives you a lot of confidence and self-esteem, and you can grow yourself as an individual, and also you can contribute to the growth and cause of your company. Then we did lot of experiments. I have been having this academic bent of mind right from beginning. So when I took over as faculty at my training institute, I was thinking that when I worked in field, there were so many problems which were encountered by us as engineers. But the problem is that the engineer sitting at one particular site does not share it with other site, although the equipment are almost the same. So if someone has come across some problem, and if that problem is shared with others, at least they will have a ready-made example that if such and such problem is coming, perhaps this is the solution. So as early as in year 98, I took the step of organizing annual knowledge and experience sharing seminar with this objective, that if the problems are similar, the people across the organization should share the experience so that we don't have to reinvent the wheel time and again if the similar kind of problems are encountered. Moreover, another advantage is that when you involve people, they contribute with their ideas. Suppose if I have come across a problem and I have found some solution, it is not necessary that it is the optimum solution. Maybe someone else can say, okay, you did a good job by coming out with this solution, but perhaps had you done like this, it would have been more efficient or more cost effective and so on. So that kind of culture building. So who says that PSU does not give you flexibility or autonomy? सेमिनार हमने शुरू किया उसका पब्लिकेशन शुरू किया उससे लोगों को थोड़ा सा एकेडमिक ब्लेंडिंग भी मिला कि पेपर कैसे लिखते हैं नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस इन इंजीनियरिंग आई नो मेनी ऑफ यू आर इंजीनियर्स आल्सो हु आर डूइंग एमबीए इंजीनियर्स गलत सलत इंग्लिश लिखते हैं और फिर उनसे हम साइट पे जब पूछते हैं कि यार क्या लिख के लाए हो आप सर हम तो इंजीनियर हैं हमारी तो ग्रामर उतनी अच्छी नहीं है अरे भाई क्यों अच्छी नहीं है आप इंजीनियर हो तो क्या आप गेहूं की रोटी के अलावा घास की रोटी खाते हो आप इंजीनियर हो तो क्या आपका परिवार नहीं है तो फिर यहां गलती करने में ही क्यों इंजीनियरिंग ले आए हो चलो बहुत जो शायद नॉन इंजीनियर से उनको मजा आया तो ये दैट मीन्स सी हमारी लाइफ जो है बड़ी इंटीग्रेटेड है ऐसा नहीं है स्प्लिट थोड़ी पर्सनालिटी है कि आप घर जाके कुछ हो जाते हो दफ्तर में आके कुछ हो जाते हो आप एक होलिस्टिक एंटिटी हो तो आप अगर इंजीनियर हो तो गलत सलत लिखने का आपको कोई हक नहीं हो गलत लिखा तो मानो कि गलत लिखा कल से सही करूँगा दैट इज़ द अप्रोच आई वॉज फॉलोइंग सो आई वॉज इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ नॉलेज एंड एक्सपीरियंस शेयरिंग सेमिनार दैट ऑल्सो हेल्प्ड in writing skills of the people, how to write a case, and what is the what a research paper or a paper in a conference looks like, what is the format, how to give the references, how to give the bibliography, and so on and so forth. So ek teer se kai shikar hue, organization ka fayda hua, individuals ka fayda hua, logon ko recognition mila ki sahab inhone site pe itna kaam kiya, itni problem aayi, aise aise mehnat karke solve kiya. So the more you involve people, the more they contribute. अगर आप वही जो जो पहले हमने बात की कि do as directed करोगे तो लोग interest lose कर जाएंगे भाई जो अगर सब कुछ ही बाला सर को करना है तो ये पादे सर या रश्मि मैडम या वो क्या नाम सोनम मैडम वो क्या करेंगे उनकी क्रिएटिविटी तो ख़त्म हो जाएगी ना सो दैट इज़ वाई ए गुड लीडर ऑलवेज एंश्योर्स इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ इट्स हिज और हर team members. Then when this lady was giving some introduction, the achievement of various awards, Indian Society for Training and Development Award or the Distinguished Scholar Award, all are because of my organization. I don't consider, D.V. Shastry is no one. It is GAIL India Limited who has given the opportunity to an individual who has made some efforts. I won't say that individual has not made any effort, but it is the organization which has given the opportunity to develop the individual himself, to contribute his bit to the success and progress of the organization, and in also developing himself or herself. That is the essence. And ये 34 साल का जो मैंने period है, उसका आपको निचोड़ बता दिया है. जैसे आपके यहाँ महाराष्ट्र में तो गन्ना खूब होता है, गन्ने की रसवंती होती है ना? तो वही मैंने आपको निकाल के बता दिया कि 34 इयर्स में क्या निकला अब ये कोई मत कहना कि पीएसयू में काम नहीं होता पीएसयू में बाबूगिरी होती है पीएसयू में ऑटोनॉमी नहीं है पीएसयू में फ्रीडम नहीं है पीएसयू में एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग का स्कोप नहीं है ऐसा नहीं है ये मैं कह रहा हूँ क्योंकि ये मैंने खुद एक्सपीरियंस किया है शायद कोई दूसरा आदमी खाली किताब पढ़ के बोलता तो आप शायद बिलीव नहीं करते लेकिन मैं आपके सामने खड़ा होकर वाउच कर रहा हूँ बट शर्त यही है अब ये मत समझ लेना कि ये सब कुछ है लेकिन जो नॉन परफॉर्मर्स हैं उनको हम टॉलरेट भी नहीं करते द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिलीव्स इन ए कल्चर ऑफ मेरिटोक्रेसी दोज हु आर परफॉर्मिंग दे आर एनकरेज्ड दे आर रिवार्डेड दे आर रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बट दोज हु डू नॉट परफॉर्म दोज हु आर इनएफिशिएंट दोज हु आर हैविंग ए नेगेटिव एटीट्यूड दे आर गिवन डिफरेंट ट्रीटमेंट टुडे The board of directors of GAIL India Limited chairman and all functional directors, they are the homegrown leaders. Nobody has been selected from outside GAIL. All have worked from, have been selected from within the organization only. Ab aap bataiye ki agar log kehte hain sab ye to system hi sada hua hai, isme kuch nahi ho sakta, to usi system mein se wo chairman kaise aa gaya? Us chairman ne bhi yahan pe 30 years se zyada ki service ki hai. Isi chalo kehte hain gandi gali mein se nikal ke, gali kuch aise nikal ke wo wahan kaise pahunch gaya? Aap kyon nahi pahunche? आप तो सिस्टम को गाली दे रहे हो कि यहाँ तो ऐसा होता है वैसा होता है, जिसको अचीव करना है वो कर गया. इसीलिए कहते हैं ना, शिव खेड़ा की एक बुक थी यू कैन विन, उसमें उन्होंने बड़ी अच्छी चीज़ कही थी कि विनर्स डोंट डू डिफरेंट थिंग्स, दे डू थिंग्स डिफरेंटली. सो दैट इज वॉट द सीक्रेट ऑफ सक्सेस इज. देन फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन, दैट्स अ वेरी very, very important thing. As I mentioned to you that we have got a very free and open communication. Just to share an example with you, there was, you know, some recruitment process going on at some point of time. And this Brahmaputra Cracker and Polymer Limited is our own subsidiary in which we have got 70% stake, and it has already come up as a petrochemical plant in the state of Assam. So when we were recruiting engineers for GAIL, some of the engineers from that subsidiary also applied for a position in GAIL. And of course, GAIL is a better organization compared to that subsidiary. But when that project was under construction and commissioning, there was a lot of pressure on the project manager there. So he had said ki hamare logon ko aap mat lijiyega. And somehow he tried to convince our chairman also that it should not be so. But when we took the interview of engineers, we found that one or two were excellent, excellent performers. So we decided to take them. But at that time, I was general manager only. Today I am ED. That time I was general manager. So I had an ED with me to whom I was reporting. I said, sir, we have selected. No. CMD has told you should not select anyone from BCPL. You have to revise the selection proceedings and this and that. I said, no, sir, we have taken a conscious decision, the committee. It is not me, it is the entire committee which has taken this decision on the basis of performance demonstrated by the people who appeared for interview. Nahi, bhai, CMD naraaz ho jayega. Maine kaha, sir, aap mujhe ijazat dijiye, main CMD se baat karta hun. Agar naraaz ho jayenge, to bhi kya hai, mere senior hai. Lekin main apni baat to rakhu. सिर्फ नाराज़ हो जाएंगे इस डर से मैं कुछ जिसको मैं उचित समझ रहा हूँ वो ना करूँ, तो वो तो फिर मेरे अंदर एक गिल्टी वो रह जाएगा कॉन्शियस. सो आई डिड दैट, आई वेंट टू CMD. CMD सॉ द लिस्ट. अरे भाई, ये आपने क्यों लिया? मैंने कहा, सर एक बात बताइए, जो अच्छा आदमी है उसको GAIL में लेना बेहतर है, क्योंकि ही इज़ विद इन अवर लार्जर पूल, दैट BCPL इज़ ऑल्सो अवर पार्ट एंड GAIL इज वी आर GAIL ओनली, तो वो तो हमारी घर की चीज़ घर में रही. आप नहीं लेंगे तो कोई दूसरा ले जाएगा. अगर उसके अंदर पोटेंशियल है, उसके अंदर टैलेंट है, तो दूसरा कोई एम्प्लॉयर ले जाएगा. CMD को एक मिनट नहीं लगा समझने में. बोले, हाँ यार, बात तो तुम सही कह रहे हो. एंड द डिसीजन टेकन बाय आवर सिलेक्शन कमिटी प्रिवेल्ड. सो माय पॉइंट इज दैट यू हैव टू बी फ्री एंड फ्रैंक इन एक्सप्रेसिंग ओपिनियन, बट एट द सेम टाइम डोंट बी एडामेंट. आई वॉज वेरी ओपन इन माई माइंड. It is good that CMD agreed to what I said, but even if he had not agreed with me, I would have been happy. I would have thought that, okay, I did my duty, I expressed my opinion, but once my senior is saying something after hearing me, that means there must be some other reasons also, which perhaps are not obvious to me, and that leader has in his mind. But I will agree only after logical reasoning. वही जो बताया, परिप्रश्न न सेवया, परिप्रश्न करके ह्यूमिलिटी के साथ अपने सीनियर्स से बात कीजिए, तो आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. लोग सोचते हैं, अरे नाराज होगा, क्यों होगा भाई, वो भी तो इंसान है, उसके अंदर भी तो लॉजिक है, उसके अंदर भी तो बुद्धि है क्या भाई? अरे वाह, जग रहे हैं? नहीं, एक दो लोग सो रहे हैं. जो सो रहे हैं वो समझ गए कौन सो रहे हैं. वो सोए रहेंगे ऐसा. तो This is some of the things which I wanted to share, and the leadership framework development in GAIL, what we are doing, it is focused on self-awareness, emotional intelligence, and emotional quotient, as we say. Again, as I said earlier also, knowledge of the business beyond the functional area. Finance wale ko technical pata hona chahiye, technical wale ko marketing pata hona chahiye, and so on. Learning agility, keeping the people themselves updated with the latest, innovative and critical thinking, strategic thinking, boundary spanning, choti soch se ek perspective ko bada karna, is pe emphasis hai, as a part of leadership development program in GAIL. The spirit of collaboration is encouraged, effective communication. It is not important what you say, it is also important how you say. So that is the core of communication that should be there in a good leader. And learning to be comfortable with ambiguity. Again, coming to the same thing. If you are faced with ambiguity, take some decision. Whatever your wisdom says, according to time, space and context. Desh, kal, paristhiti. Ye cheez aap hamesha dhyan rakhiye. Indian philosophy ya Indian scriptures ko log sochte hai ki wo bekar hai, puran panthi hai. No. Wo Harvard wale ne keh diya, time, space and context. हम कहते हैं साहब देखो कितना बढ़िया पेपर आया और एक आदमी देश काल परिस्थिति कहता है बोले ये तो भाई पोंगा पंडित है इसलिए वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड द एसेंस वी शुड नॉट गो गेट बायस्ड दैट व्हाट इज सेड वेयर एंड व्हेन एंड बाय होम सो द मेजर ड्राइवर्स ऑफ आवर लीडरशिप प्रोग्राम आर इमिनेटिंग फ्रॉम The strategy 2020, which was framed by us in the year 2011, and capacity and capability building. These are the two major imperatives of our HR strategy out of the entire business strategy. So we have to align our HR strategy with the overall business strategy, and capacity building and capability building. These are the two major areas which are, guiding the philosophy of our leadership development in GAIL. So, then there are two parts, developing existing capabilities, like we have excellent capabilities in contract management, project management, risk management, regulatory management, etc. And we are also venturing into the new aspects of business. So, acquiring and developing new capabilities for business like shale gas business, international trading, LNG sourcing, renewable business, shipping, and mergers and acquisitions, and so on. So, based on these two needs, there was a need for concerted efforts for talent development at senior level. So, we started assessment centers or the SMDC, Senior Management Development Centers, for the senior level management, and the purpose was to identify suitable incumbents for the challenging assignments and future leadership roles. Again, in this context, I would like to share the concept of job sculpting. There are two very good authors, James Waldrop and Timothy Butler. They came out with a very good paper in the Harvard Business Review. They say that just like a sculptor chisels the stone and gives it the shape of a sculpture or a murti, similarly, the job sculpting also helps the organization. That means you have to identify the real potential and the aptitude of the employee and try to, assign that kind of job so that the individual is really, happy in performing that kind of task and he is happy and organization is also benefited. This is, mind you, this is different from the concept of right man for the right job. This is much beyond that. But definitely we are having shortage of time, so that I leave it to you. If you have interest, you can search on Google for job sculpting and you can get lot of literature. So this job sculpting is also very important in identifying the suitable leaders for suitable positions. So we covered the officers of the level of E5 and above. That is chief managers, DGMs, general managers, chief general managers, and executive directors, And so far we have exposed more than 700 officers of that level till date, and the process continues. This is how the process was taken up. The competency framework was designed first, then development center was conducted, and after conduction of the center, the areas of strength and areas of development for all the individuals were identified, and to address those areas, individual development programs were taken up. As a part of that individual development program, there were suggested readings, that is the books by renowned management experts were distributed in the relevant areas. Harvard Managementor, the e-learning modules, we took from the Harvard Managementor and made 44 modules available to all such executives, and organized customized modules at IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bangalore, and ISB Hyderabad, which includes the post-course work and post-course project and reflection mechanism. These are some of the books which were distributed to such senior level officers across, access to all 44 e-learning modules, as I mentioned. This is the screenshot of how our module look like, and you can find a combination of the modern and the Indian flavor. It is I take the credit, yes. Normally it should be we, but I named it as e-gyan pravah, e-initiative, but there should be a flavor of Indianness in everything. We should take pride in saying that we are Indians. We should learn and adopt whatever is good from wherever. Like again, Chanakya had said, Baladapi Subhashitam Grahyam. That means even if a small child says something worthwhile, we must adopt it. So if something is good in the US, we must adopt it. If something is good in Sri Lanka, we must adopt it. We should not discard that it is from a country like Nepal, so we should discard it. Nepal has also good things, and there are many bad things in US also. So you have to apply your wisdom and take pride in our own culture, values, and systems. Again, another screenshot. This customized programs at various institutes of repute. Then also the system of giving challenging assignments and job rotation to the executives, like I quoted my own example, rotation in so many functions. And there is also a very strong focus on the new entrants. When the new entrants come to our organization for joining, these are the two key programs, that is Shubharam, which is again a name in alignment with Indian culture, Shubharam and Sarathi. Shubharam is the induction cum orientation program specially designed for the executive trainees who join us, which is an year-long program which consists of so many things, like, you know, the first 2.5 months are given for lecturing methods, so that the newcomers are, they are posted at the real work centers, and at the end of 6 months there is a midterm review, at the end of the complete year there is a final term review, and so on. And second thing is mentoring, which was not prevailing in many of the public sectors earlier. Now of course the number of PSUs having this thing is increasing, but GAIL was a pioneer in implementing this, and the concept of this is again drawn from Gita. Like when Arjun had let down his weapons in the battlefield, he said that karpanya dosho pahata swabhava, etc. That means he says to Krishna that now I am confused about my duty and I have lost my composure because of miserly weakness, and in this condition I am asking you to tell me. So why this is the inspiration? Because when a newcomer comes to the organization, jaise ghar mein nayi bahu aati hai, ho sakta hai ki ladka ladki to aajkal ek dusre ko jante hai ki adhiktar cases mein, लेकिन लड़की जब जाती है तो जरूरी नहीं है कि लड़के की माँ से एक्वेंटेड हो या उसके फादर से या दूसरे, तो उसका भी एक ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम होता है कि नहीं? बोले फॉर्मल नहीं होता। तो उसको भी टाइम लगता है घर में, अच्छा भाई भाई उसके घर में वो सब्जी उस तरह से बनती थी, इनके घर में इस तरह से बनती है, एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर, सो इट टेक्स टाइम। सो व्हेन द एम्प्लॉई जॉइन्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, द इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयर टू डू द हैंड होल्डिंग ऑफ द न्यूली जॉइंड एम्प्लॉई, एंड देयरफॉर देयर हैज टू बी अ मेंटर अटैच्ड विद एवरी न्यू एम्प्लॉई, एंड वी मेड इट श्योर दैट हूसोएवर जॉइंस कंपनी ही और शी इज असाइंड अ मेंटर, एंड दैट मेंटर इज नेसेसरीली from a function which is not in his or her normal hierarchy, because if someone from the hierarchy is assigned, then the new person will not share everything freely. And mentor is someone who is a senior person who has lot of experience, he has personal experience, he has professional experience, so the new person can share the difficulties, the apprehensions with that fellow, and that fellow can guide the newcomer and help him or her to align with the values, beliefs, systems, ethos, policies, processes, procedures of the companies, and over a period of time, and you will be very surprised to know that this mentor-mentee relationship is such that it is a lifelong relationship. And one more advantage of mentorship is reverse mentoring. It is not that only mentor which is giving something to the mentee. It is mentee also having a lot of good qualities from which the mentor can learn. So this is reverse mentoring, and that has created a very good environment in the organization. So I know it is already 1:20, you are all waiting for the lunch. So I will not come between you and lunch. So I conclude by saying that while we talk of disruptive innovation, we talk of artificial intelligence, we talk of digitization, and so on and so forth, nothing to worry. We have three kinds of intelligence. IQ, that is intelligence quotient, EQ is emotional quotient, but the most important is spiritual quotient, which integrates IQ and EQ, and it is nothing but the intelligence with which we address and solve the problems of meaning and value. And in our tradition of rishis and philosophers, they have also given special emphasis to experiential learning, and they have highlighted the importance in relation to building of character and imbibing spiritual values, that is the SQ. So it is the spiritual values, because whatever impressions we are having in our mind, they give rise to the intentions give shape our thoughts result into action to reaction, and this circle keeps continuing. So it is at the impression level where we have to imbibe the spiritual values to make a good spiritual life. Spirituality has no relation with religion. It is only the vivek or the wisdom to do what is right and what is not, and to develop a positive value system. So since I am here at Pune, which is the cultural capital of Maharashtra, I will conclude by quoting a song from a Marathi film. It says, tu buddhi de tu tej de navachetana vishwas de je satya sundara sarvatha a janma tyacha dhyas de. And more important, it says, there are so many stanzas, but the stanza which is of relevance now, that is adherence to the values, it says, sanmarga ani sanmati labho sada satsangati niti nahi bhrasht ho jari sankate alikiti pankhasaya balde nave je pavanya akashade जय सत्य सुंदर सर्वथा आजन्म त्याचा ध्यास दे तू बुद्धि दे तू तेज दे नव चेतना विश्वास दे. थैंक यू.
The house is now open for a question answer round.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Rohit Arya from BIIB Marketing. First of all, thank you for clearing the myths related to PSUs. So my question is, sir, that you mentioned that the attrition rate is less than 1%. So apart from the fact that it's a government job and people have job security, what other things are you doing at your organization that's keeping the attrition rate so low?
Yes, please sit down.
So I can speak normally.
As I mentioned to you during interaction with you, we have created such a culture, such a conducive culture where people feel that their potential is recognized by the company, their good work is rewarded and recognized, they have got fair treatment within the company, they have got reasonable chances of growth. People have a belief that if genuine mistakes are committed, the organization is going to forgive and accommodate such things. They don't have fear. Agar genuine galti ho gayi to koi aapko phansi pe latkane wala nahi hai, lekin janboojh ke karoge to uska dusra treatment hoga. To is tarah ki jo culture hai, organization culture, I will summarize by saying that we have a culture which is characterized by octopus. Octopus is nothing but openness, collaboration, trust, that is mutual trust. P is proaction, A is authenticity of actions by the leaders. And the second one is confrontation, as I said, open discussion. Even if you have divergent views, there is healthy discussion, and E is experimenting. So this octopus is something which is binding the people, which is making them stick to the organization. Isme ek counter school of thought ye bhi hota hai, jaise aapne kaha ki attrition kam hai, iska matlab ye hota hai ki bhai aapko aur kahin job nahi mil raha tha isliye aap pade ho, ek aisa notion bhi hota hai, lekin I can tell you aisa nahi hai. At least main apne taur pe keh sakta hu ki market mein mere paas bahut se job the bhi, lekin because of this strong culture of this company, that I and many others are sticking to the company, and those who have resigned from the company are repenting. Kai log gaye dusre private companies mein dekhke ki itna package utna package, lekin baad mein jaake wo rote hain ki bhai humne GAIL chhodke zindagi ki sabse badi galti ki. Does that answer your question?
Thank you, sir, for enlightening us about the knowledge leadership and the quest for knowledge, gyan pipasa, which constitutes of the basis for leadership, and the antidote for VUCA, which is vision understand beyond functional area, clarity of thought and agility. May I now